What's up, guys? Catastrophe SB here with part 6 of Pokemon Black and White walkthrough on No Faint Challenge. A little thing before I start, sorry about the last video and the last video before. They were a little screwed up because of my stupid iPod. I had a little trouble with my storage. But other than that, let's continue. I just beat them two right there, and we are going to visit the preschool up here. Right beside is the daycare if you're having trouble training your Pokemon. We don't have time for it, though. So we're just going to rest here. It's pretty much like a quick pit stop. And we're just going to keep on going. And we'll put Pants here first. And there's Charon. Now here's a heads up. Every time you win a badge, a little bit after, you are gonna have to battle him. So be ready for him. He still has his Snivy. We're gonna keep this fire type here, Pansear, until we get the fire type I want, and that's not gonna be for a while. So he's gonna be on our team for a while. He's growing up there. I'm surprised he didn't use a super potion. Let's switch out because this guy ain't doing too good. His attack kind of sucks. For a fire type, that's pretty bad. Oh, that was a bad idea. Oh crap. Oh crap. Oh crap. No! Bad idea, bad idea, bad idea. Very bad idea. Do not ever do that again. Okay, that was the closest thing ever. I'm being very concerned right now. All right. Heal up there. Moving right along. Double battle. No single battle. I was wrong. I don't know why I was thinking double battle. That's Fury Swipe. And he uses Leer. I had to miss, really. and I only had to hit it twice. Oh crap. Oh crap, I should have not done that. Yeah, that was not a good idea. What's one good thing about this challenge is it goes to the very end of the game and it will affect your playtime on this game, and it will affect the story too, and it will affect your anger. Okay, he better do his fair share. There you go. If he gets down, no one really cares about Snivy. Alright, one down. Poor Snivy getting hit over there. Alright guys, we are going to go over to the center down here, and we're going to heal up, and I'm going to go do something quick. I'm going to go get some repels, and I'm going to go capture a Pokemon here that I really want, that's really going to help out on our offense instead of defense. But first I need to go get some repels. So I'm going to way down here, and I'm not going to go the whole way back up to the other Pokemon Center, because that's just a waste of time. We'll buy an escape rope, buy an awakening, we already have an antidote, so we'll get a paralyzed heal, we'll get 3 super potions just in case in battle, and then we'll be good. Hopefully we get a bike soon. We get in like the third town, so we'll get it soon, sooner or later. But if you go down here, we are gonna go through this grass here. But there's no Pokemon I want, so I'm gonna use a repel going through here. We're gonna battle this one person quick. Level 9, really? Okay, this is a little too sad. Pretty strong, though. We need our Pokemon to evolve before the second gym leader to do some damage. Because I swear, we're going to do terrible if we don't get him up. So I'm going to let Lillipup do the rest of the talking here. Lillipup is really good on attack, which that's what I love. Problem is, I got a stupid female instead of a male, and no, I am not sexual like that. I feel kind of bad, but I was thinking of getting a Pidove, but I really don't think we need a flying type, to be honest. If we do need a flying type, I have one in mind. So, we won't have to worry about it for a while. Level 14. Now there's an Ordinberry, which we definitely need to use, and there's a Repel that we can use. Alright, now we're gonna heal up a little bit for people that need it. We have all these potions, holy crap, we need to use them. Alright, we're gonna go in here, and we are gonna capture a Pokemon that is not really easily captured. So we got Thief, we're not really going to use that. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to run around in circles. But we're going to use a Repel here. Now just watch what happens. Pretty sure it pops up here. Come on. There it is. Yes! There he is, ladies and gentlemen. A Drillbur, yeah. Okay, we're gonna lick it. Gonna paralyze it. Make sure we don't die. Now it's a ground type. We can use that. But then it goes into a steel type when it evolves. And then its attack increases anonymously. Like, terribly. So that's why I'm gonna catch it. We're gonna catch it with a heal ball so he can heal up so we don't have to go back to the Pokemon Center. And that's not working out. So now we're gonna hit it again. Maybe we should change Pokemon, maybe that'll help. I'm catching this, it's the last thing I do. Let's try Great Ball. Ross got it. There we go, guys. That is the capture of the day. Now we are going to go down and heal up. And what I'm going to do now, off camera, is I'm going to put him into the daycare, and I've done something lately that has worked. Now, for every step you take once he's in the daycare, that's one XP he earns. So, sure, it's going to cost us a lot, but it is definitely going to be worth it. So I'm going to stop here, and I'm going to go do some running for a little bit until he goes up to like level 14 with all the rest of the guys, so he'll be able to fight. And next up, we're going to go on to the next route and make our way to the second town. Well, not the second town, but the other town. So don't forget to subscribe to Catastrophe SB, and don't forget to continue on with our journey through the Unova region.